Hey guys, so this video I wanted to talk about grip fighting. Grip fighting is one of the most important aspects of jiu-jitsu, both for defense and offense from your guard. Before you can do any attack, you have to set up a guard or a control that you can attack from, and grip fighting is the ability to stop your opponent from passing you and setting up your position before they do. Before I get into the video, be sure to like and comment to help support the channel. So the first thing to understand with grip fighting is it's going to be dictated a lot by the guards that you know, right? So I can show you how to set up De La Hiva guard, but if you don't know how to control De La Hiva guard, it's less useful. So I'm going to do this video supposing that you know pretty much all of the guards. And if I show you a setup to a position that you don't know how to play, that's okay. You know how to set it up, and now look for separate videos to learn how to play it in depth. So the first thing to understand is that we have to build off of the grips they're giving us, not what we want, okay? So the first thing I always want to do is I want to make sure I'm keeping distance. A lot of people have a bad habit of grip fighting and they stay stationary, and the closer my opponent is to me, the easier it is for him to pass me, okay? So for example, if I'm on my back and my opponent just steps around my guard over here like this, if he's really far away, even though he's around my guard, it's pretty easy for me to lasso my leg over or find some way to come back. I'm not really in trouble until he gets really close to me. Right now, he's around me, but also it's hard to find the space, right? So I'm always trying to manage distance. So this is really easy to mess up when you're setting up. So a lot of people will be here like this and he's engaging, and now if he does a quick move over here like this or something, I'm suddenly way out of position, right? So what I always want to be doing is when I'm grip fighting is I'm always kind of backing up. It's like a jab in boxing, okay? So if he's approaching, I'm always kind of managing distance like this, and I'm trying to grip fight as I'm backing up. If he starts backing away, I'll follow him, right? But I always want to make sure I have distance, because if I make a big mess up or something, just go slow. If I make a big mess up where I think I'm going here and then suddenly he goes around here, if I have all this distance, it's much easier for me to come back and reset the position or to fall back to my guard and lasso, okay? So always manage the distance, okay? So now the first grip I'm gonna build off is always gonna be the grip that he's giving me, okay? So if I'm like obsessed with trying to grab the legs and his hands are really forward, then as I'm going for the legs, he's gonna be grabbing my lapel or framing, and I'm allowing him to make a grip. So I'm always backing up and I'm looking for the first grip possible. So usually sleeves is one of the first grip options, because for him to do literally anything, he has to grip with his hands, okay? So a lot of times I'll either go for a cuff or I like this low forearm grip, okay? This one's really good because it's very easy to get a lot of times. Like getting the cuff sometimes can be like hard, the guy's gi may be short, but this will always get, okay? If I get a sleeve grip, the grips I'm usually gonna build off of this are either gonna be falling straight to a foot on the hip, and then this can turn into collar sleeve, and from here I can start attacking triangles. If he pulls his elbow tight, I can start going to like a De La Hiva hook, and I can start building with that. If I get a hold of a sleeve, usually this one's more with a cuff, if I get a hold of a sleeve and his like elbow and knee are a little bit tighter, you know, sometimes I'll just fall back to a lasso here. And then now I can go to collar sleeve. I can, if he grabs here, I could go to double sleeve. Realistically, you could switch collar, ankle, and you can start building from there. So whatever grip you enter with, you don't have to play that the whole time. You can just enter with collar sleeve. And even if you're not good at it, you can play it just long enough to switch up to an ankle grip or switch up to double sleeve to a position you like to play more. Also, what is useful is to be able to build off either sleeve, okay? So if I'm looking for this sleeve, but he's like leading with his other leg and he's got this hand forward and I'm too caught chasing the sleeve I want, now he's making a grip and initiating attack before me, right? So again, if he gives me this one, fine, I take this grip, right? I can go foot on hip or a lasso. I fall back and now maybe he grabs this one. This is my preferred grip. Fine. Now I take that, I break, lasso, and now I can build from here. The main thing is build off of the initial grips they're giving you and keeping the distance. So another really common grip sequence is we're gonna be looking for the sleeves. We can't get it, so we're gonna go to the collar. Okay, once I get the collar, I did an entire video on this just called the most aggressive guard in BJJ. I just call it the collar guard. But basically from here, I can do like collar drags and come up on a single leg. You know, if he backs up a little bit, I can like ankle pick and come up. I can jump to like single leg X like this. I can set up De La Hiva here and go like that. So there's a lot of things you can do with the collar grip, either setting up De La Hiva, or if he leads with the other leg even, and I have this, I can pull into like reverse De La Hiva. So there's a lot of options you can do with this collar grip. And again, I would watch that entire video if you wanna go really in depth on that. But one of the other really common things that'll happen is he'll go to break this grip. When he goes to break the grip, that always gives me the sleeve. So he breaks, boom, now I got the sleeve again. And again, from the sleeve, I could go to foot on hip. I could fall back to lasso. I could start building from here. If he leads with the other leg, right? I could grab this ankle and now I'm playing De La Hiva on the other side and I'm building from there. Another situation will be the guy's in, and now every time I go for the collar, he's up a little bit more. So as soon as I go for the collar, he breaks it before I, like, so fast I can't even try to get this because he just denies it immediately, okay? So if my opponent is denying a high collar, they're denying the sleeve, there's a few different options I can do here. One is I can go for like a grip on the knee here because he has to be up to deny that collar grip. So I can just catch the knee here, jump and pull in on the leg, and now I've established De La Hiva. And again, this just turns into how good you are at playing De La Hiva. So from here, you might look for this. I get the sleeve, I break, and now I'm going into sit-up guard. I could start taking him backwards and go for Baron Bolos and build from there as well, okay? So now you're building this way, okay? So I look for his sleeve, he's hiding the sleeve. I go for the collar, he's breaking it. I can go here or here. Both will work. I like the inside when I can get it because I can kind of pull around like that to jump in. Another really good one, if he's denying all the grips, is going straight for the belt. So like I'm here, I go for the sleeve, I can't get it, I get the belt, and now I'm just gonna pull in, I put my foot on the hip, and I pull here, and now I can start going straight into a Baron Bolo like that as well. Okay, another grip to build off, again, this is preference, but is a good single leg grip. So if he's leading with his leg, again here, instead of going for like the pan grip to go to De La Hiva, I can step in and get on the knee. If his arms are more engaged and he's low, get your legs back and have your upper body forward. Right, if he's here and I go for a single leg, he can like stiff arm my shoulder and it's hard to get really tight on a good single leg or a half guard game. But if he's standing up really tall, denying the sleeve and the collar and stuff, he leaves this really open to get a good tight grip. From here, go around this way, David. From here, like this, right, I can get a really tight grip like this, right? So if he's down, I can't get that tight grip. But what makes this tight is when he's up, I can come in and I'm really behind the knee. Now it's hard for him to knee cut here because he can't dig an underhook. And now I can put my foot up here. I can start grabbing the sleeve, feed this. I could just come up straight for a single leg. Even if he tries to push this down, he gives me the sleeve. Now I can come out. I could transition back to an open guard and start building from here. So again, the main idea is the more connection points you have, the easier it is going to be for you to stop the guy from getting any form of offense started, and then you can start connecting to whatever you want. So another big aspect of like grip fighting is like, again, I break my jiu-jitsu always down into positions, so you have different attack series from different positions. So this position we're in is like no grips position, okay? So from the grip fight, I can either set up a guard or I can go directly to an attack, right? So it's very useful to add that in because like I can be looking here to go to spider guard and stuff, but a few basic like quick attacks that can be really effective and offset your opponent. One is an arm drag. So if I'm here and I get a hold of the sleeve, the guy thinks I'm gonna fall back to a lasso or foot on the hip. But sometimes when I'm here, just pushing this across, catching this, I kick out the far leg, go to that side, okay? Like just pushing this across, kicking out the far leg here can be really easy to come up for an arm drag to the back or to a single leg, and I can finish there. So mixing direct attacks in your grip fight on top of just setting up guards can be very powerful as well. Another good one when the guy's being really grip breaky and he's square stanced is like this, is the old Marcelo one where you go here, you catch this and you just push and clip them out like that and come up. That one can be really good when the guy's posturing up a lot. There, David was kind of hunkered in more, but like posture up. So break grips a bunch. He's like breaking grips. I go here, break the grip like this. That's a very good one that you can come up, right? And just a few of those things added in is going to make the guy respect you more and make it easier to set up some of the other grips. Another one that's actually really simple, but very, very effective is if you're hearing the guy's posturing up a lot, Leandro Lowe did this to Hamilo Bahal, where he was here and he was grip fighting. He backed up a bit and then Hamilo stayed really postured up and he just blast double legged him from here. Right, and that can actually be shockingly effective when the person is used to you falling back to your guard. They tend to bring their body weight back so much, it makes it really easy to do a strong drive forward into an attack. One other really good one, when he's up tall like this and he's denying the sleeves and collars, I do think the sleeve and collars are the most important to build off because most people will engage with you, but some people are just very grip breaky, right? So when that happens, you can either do like a low lapel, right, which Keenan has a ton of content on this. You could do a low lapel or you could do a belt. Andres does this a lot as well. And because he's up so much, he's not engaging, it's easy to get stuff like this. And from here, I could immediately jump in and start feeding here, and then this can start turning into like Polish worm rider with a belt. I could switch out and start feeding up to worm, and you can just start building all sorts of things with the belt there. If you have the lapel as well, you can do a similar idea and pull in here. I could start switching up the squid and build here and play all that stuff. Again, I'm not really a big lapel guard player, so if you want to see more of that stuff, I would check out Andres Bernofsky or Keenan. But just conceptually with the grip fighting game, it's very useful to understand that because you're always trying to build off of what they are giving you. So when they're up really high with their posture like that and they're not exposing a good lapel or a good sleeve, being able to build off like the low lapel or the belt is a great option, especially if you already play that kind of a game. Just a couple thoughts as well about butterfly guard, because it's a really popular guard, but in modern jiu-jitsu, it depends on what you mean by butterfly guard, because you can call it, like, traditionally when people say butterfly guard, like Marcelo Garcia would refer to this as playing butterfly. So I'm sitting here and I can set up quick attacks from here and stuff. And then there's butterfly, like go to both knees on the floor, kind of like Adam Wardzinski kind of made it more popular recently, but being in really tight with like a good overhook or an underhook, grabbing the wrist and doing these kind of sweeps, that's really good as well. But that position requires a lot more setup, okay? It's not like, it's analogous to like close guard or X guard. They're not like really entry grips. It's hard to just start off there. So to get to a position like that, you almost have to play another guard. Like Adam, go at stand up. Like Adam plays a lot like of like collar sleeve positions and stuff, and he might be playing here or something, you know, and I could bring a guy down and he's defending my collar sleeve stuff. Go around that way. Stay there. Yeah. He might come down like this, and then I might be able to start pulling in from here and building up to this stuff. Okay, so again, I wouldn't consider like that kind of classic butterfly game as part of the grip fighting series. That's something that you need to build more to set up. A couple ways you could set it up just off my head. One I like is if the guy's on both knees on the floor, is if I'm playing like a lasso game, sometimes it's very hard to play like a spider or get the attack. I just switch to a cross sleeve and I unlasso and drag this across and come into a belt grip, drag the arm across. And now from here, I can progress to the back. If he turns his body weight back into me like this, you know, I can use this here to flip and roll out that way. And that kind of a butterfly game can be really good as well. All right, guys, thanks for watching. As always, if you guys like the channel, be sure to like, subscribe, and comment. Also, I have more free content on my website. If you haven't checked it out yet, I'll put the link in the description. And I have a lot more organized content and systems on there that are a lot harder to put on the format of YouTube. Thanks, guys.